Next concept that we are going to discuss now is the concept of tangents and normals. Now, as I already discussed with you, the geometrical interpretation of dy by dx is going to be used over here. Correct? So, when we have any function's curve, correct? And I draw a tangent at any point, let's say the point is alpha comma beta. Okay. I draw a tangent at this point. Then what is the slope of this tangent? What is the slope of this tangent?
Y is equal to f of
I. Yes, slope of this tangent is nothing but the derivative, let me write it like this. The derivative of the function
at alpha beta.
Please note, many students forget to substitute the point in dy by dx. So that is going to be wrong. Slope has to be a number, a value that you will obtain when you substitute the coordinates of the point in place of x and y in the dy by dx expression. Do not use the expression of dy by dx and call it as the slope. It is not the slope, it is the expression for the slope where you have to put in the values of x and y as required. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
And if I ask you what is the equation of this tangent, it becomes very simple. Y minus beta is equal to slope of the tangent x minus alpha. This will give you the equation of tangent. Let's say I call this point as P. Equation of tangent drawn at P. Is that okay? Similarly, what is the normal? What's the normal? It's a line which is perpendicular to the tangent drawn at that point. Normal is not perpendicular to the curve. It is perpendicular to the tangent drawn at that point. See, angle between a line and a curve is very difficult to find out. So we say it's the angle between a line and a line, where one line is the normal and other line is the tangent drawn at that point. So it is actually making a 90 degree with the tangent drawn at that point. So this line is a normal when it is making a 90 degree angle with the tangent there. So if mt is the slope of the tangent, what is the slope of the normal?
Minus dx by dy
at alpha beta. Or you can say minus 1 by dy by dx at alpha beta, which is nothing but minus 1 by mt. So the equation of the normal would be y minus beta is minus 1 by mt x minus alpha. This will be the equation of normal at p. Recording. We'll be giving you the recording for that. Coordinate geometry is from class 11, right?
No.
3D geometry.
No, sir. Coordinate.
We have to do parabola, hyperbola.
That's what? Only section, right? We're sending you the recording. Is it okay? Please avoid using this formula, or this formula will not work. If you are given a point external to the curve and from there you are drawing a tangent to the curve, this formula will not work there. In that case, you cannot say dy by dx at that point will give you the slope of the tangent drawn it to that curve.
Substitute.
Right? Then there is a different way to approach.
Y plus y by dy.
Yeah, we'll take that up. We'll take a question where I'm drawing a tangent from external point. Is that okay? Oh, you were also playing. Good. Health means nothing to you. Just the old people keep saying health is wealth. Health is nothing. dying once then you'll be playing. You realize when people are dependent on you, it's very important to be healthy. I'll definitely fall sick. Tomorrow I'll get 3 messages, unable to attend test because fell sick. I was playing in the rain during the break time. Is this okay? Now, couple of things to be noted over here. The point where this tangent meets the x-axis, let me call it as t. And the point where this normal meets the x-axis, let me call it as n. So here PT is called the length of the tangent. I know it may sound weird to you because I'm saying a length of a line, right? So, but that's how it is defined. The length of the tangent is defined as the part of the tangent which is intercepted between the point of tangency and where it meets the x-axis. So in questions and all, if you see x-axis, defined as x-axis. So in question, if you see, find the length of the tangent, that means they are asking you this. Similarly, PN is called or defined as the length of the normal. PN is defined as the length of the normal. If I drop a perpendicular from P on the x-axis, and let's say I call this point as M, then MN or MT first is called the length of subtangent. So what is subtangent? Subtangent is nothing but the projection of the tangent on the x-axis. So if they say find the length of subtangent, means they are talking about the length MT. Similarly, MN is called the length of the subnormal. Okay. Now next we are going to do one thing. We are going to find out what are these parameters, what is the length of tangent, length of normal, length of subtangent, length of subnormal. When I know the point of tangency and I know the curve. Okay. Meanwhile, I am going to erase this part. All of you have noted this down. Again, one reminder quickly. Slope is dy by dx at that point. I have seen people missing out this, putting this point back. If you don't know the point, at least put x1, y1 there. Don't leave it as xy. You yourself would get confused. Assume some point x1, y1 or alpha, beta, a, comma, b. But don't choose x, comma, y point. Alright, now the question is, if I know the curve and I know the point, that means I know the derivative of the function at alpha beta, and let's say that is y dash. Okay, in terms of y dash, alpha and beta, can you give me these four parameters, these four things: length of tangent, length of normal, length of subtangent, length of subnormal. You can only use y dash, you can only use alpha, and you can only use beta. Nothing else should be used.
Y dash will give you
y dash is nothing but slope of the tangent at that point alpha beta. Its value is known to you and I am calling it as y dash. You want, you can call it as m for the time being, no issues. So in terms of m, alpha, beta, give me these four things. This is subtangent. This is subnormal. subtangent circumference. However, You remember it in any format you want to remember it. But remember this, student, because in exam, if a question directly comes, normally they'll ask you in regional entrance exams. Then you can't sit and derive the formula for the length of normal, tangent, subtangent, subnormal. Alpha, beta, they will write it as x1, y1 sometimes. So let's say you are referring to your module and you see x1, y1 written, then don't get confused. It's just that alpha, beta, my alpha, beta is there x1, y1. This. See, if I introduce this within the root sign, what will happen? This will go within the root sign as m square, correct? So m square by m square is 1, and 1 by m square is 1 by m whole square. Is that okay? Please note down this result and keep this in mind. Next, what will be the length of the normal?
Beta into MT, beta root over MT square.
Beta
root
over
MT square. Yeah, yes. Can I edit this? So mod y1 under root 1 plus dy by dx calculated at x1 y1 whole square. Similarly, can we work out length of subtangent?
Beta by f. Mod.
Mod beta by f. Mod of? Beta by f, correct?
Yeah.
Others please, derive it fast. This is mod beta and this is 180 minus theta. So what is MT length? You would say tan theta, or we can say MT by mod beta is equal to cot 180 minus theta mod, which is nothing but mod of cot theta, which is nothing but mod of 1 by tan theta. Okay, so MT is nothing but mod beta by mod tan theta, which is mod M. So you can say mod of this. Many books will write it as mod y1 by mod of dy by dx calculated at x1, y1. Similarly, Mn. Yeah. Now, if this is 90, this is 180 minus theta, can I say this is theta minus 90?
Yeah.
Right? So, again, Mn by Pm would be cot mod of cot theta minus 90, which is as good as saying mod of tan theta, which is as good as saying mod of M. So Mn will be mod M times Pm, which is mod beta. So you can say mod of M beta, which you can say mod y1 times mod of dy by dx calculated at x1, y1. So all these four results should be known. Is that okay? Now a couple of things which will help you save time. Everything can I use it? So a couple of things related to tangent that will help you save time. One is, when you are aware that you are dealing with a conic section, and if you remember, I have discussed this with you earlier also, if you want to draw the tangent at x1, y1 to a conic section whose equation is the second degree general equation, whether it's a parabola, ellipse, hyperbola, circle, they all follow the second degree general equation. Then I told you a trick that simply substitute your or replace your x square with
x,
x one, y square with
y
y one, x y with
x
y one plus x one y by two, y with x plus x one by two, y with y plus y one by two, and C, let it be C. When you do these replacements into these, into the equation of the conic given to you, you automatically get to the equation of the tangent. So you don't have to take a longer route finding dy by dx at x1, y1 and then using the formula y minus y1 equal to mx minus x1. So this is a simpler approach to finding the equation of a tangent to a conic. Please do not use this if you do not have a second degree general equation. So if it is a cubic equation, do not use that. Secondly, Can I erase this off? Secondly, if you realize that you're given a curve which passes through origin, okay? If you're given a curve which passes through origin and you're asked to find the tangent to that curve at origin, okay? Then the tangent would be simply the lowest degree term equated to zero. It is simply the lowest degree terms equated to zero. Take for example, I have a circle x square plus y square minus 3x plus 2y equal to zero. Correct? It's a circle. How do I know it's passing through origin?
Because if you substitute 0,
that anybody can do. Simpler way is it will not have any constant term except for 0. That is the 0. Right? So, when a curve is passing through origin, it will not have any non-zero constant term. That signifies it is passing through origin. Now, if I ask you find the derivative or find the equation of the tangent to this circle at origin, your answer will be simply minus 3x plus 2y equal to 0. That's it. The lowest degree terms equated to 0, that is going to be your answer. Let's verify it. First of all, if I want to find the tangent at origin, I want to know the slope at origin. Okay. Can I use implicit differentiation?
Yeah.
So let's find dy by dx at origin by using the formula minus dou f by dou x by dou f by dou y. So what is minus dou f by dou x? 2x minus 3. Dou f by dou y will be 2y plus 2. And also substitute 0, 0 in place of x and y, you get minus 3 by 2. Now according to the equation of the straight line, y minus 0 is equal to
minus 3 by
slope times
x.
Slope times
x minus
0. Oh, there's a minus sign here, sorry. Equal to slope times x minus 0. So this clearly gives me 2y is equal to 3x, or minus 3x plus 2y equal to 0. So we get the same answer. So why to go such a long route when you know this property? Remember, curve should pass through origin and you are drawing a tangent at origin. Then only save your time. The lowest degree expression, put it to 0. For example, if I ask you y square is equal to 4x, write down the equation of the tangent at origin.
Minus
4x. We'll say 4x is 0 or x is 0, right? Which is nothing but the y axis. And you can imagine it also. Y axis is the tangent at the vertex. Correct? Should I erase this? Now consider a curve, x cube plus y cube minus 3xy equal to 0, okay? It is known graphically that the plot of this curve is like this.
Wow.
Okay. And this curve is popularly called as folium of Decatur.
What does folium mean?
Kind of a loop. Okay. Now, a very extraordinary thing about this curve is that you would realize that the y-axis is tangent also at the origin and is normal also at the origin. The y axis is the tangent at the origin also. Imagine this point. It is touching and going that this part of the loop, and it is perpendicular to this part of the loop. So at the very same point, The same line is behaving as a tangent also and normal also. And same is true for x-axis as well. Origin.
Normal to the origin and tangent.
Y-axis is both normal to the origin and tangent to the origin, and x-axis also both normal to the origin and tangent to the origin. So this is some special cases where you would realize that a very same line is playing two roles. It is tangent also at the same point and normal also at the same point. Right? And you can realize how, because let's say this is a curve passing through origin, right?